This is a vintage sewing machine. It's about 100 years old and completely made out of steel. Most importantly for us, it is actually heavy AF. So the challenge for today is that by the end of the video, I'm gonna be lifting this machine with just my pinky finger and very little effort. No training involved, no gym, no tricks. Just some clever physics that we will learn along the way. Come with us. So hello, I'm Alvaro again with Omni Calculator, and today we're gonna lift this beautiful machine up without any effort. So some of you might be thinking that I'm just very weak, but to be honest, this is quite a heavy machine, as you can see. A bit under 13 kilos, which means that if we want to lift this up, we're gonna have to get very clever. Fortunately, I know just the man. It's Archimedes, the Greek that helped us put Perry in the sky. You can see the video here. Today, however, we're not gonna talk about buoyancy. We're gonna talk about mechanical advantage. And Archimedes knew about this with two major devices, levers and pulleys. With levers, he has a famous quote saying, "Give me a fulcrum and I shall move the world." And with pulleys, apparently, he was able to lift warships under his own power, just using a bunch of pulleys. For us, levers are no-go because my room is too small, but pulleys take much less space, so let's go get them. Here we have a simple pulley with a roller in the middle, and the way to use it is to wrap a rope around it and then pull on one of the ends. In this situation, all the force I put on one end is exactly the force that's been applied on the other end. There is no force multiplication, therefore there is no mechanical advantage. We're only changing the direction of the force, which might not seem like much, but it means that now I can use my weight and the force of gravity to pull objects upwards. So now let's build a two pulley system. We have our previous pulley and we have anchored the rope. In this situation, when we attach an object to the movable pulley and we pull down on the end of the rope, we lift the object up. Whatever force I apply on this end will be multiplied by 2 on the object. And here's why. So let's say I put 1 kilogram of force on this end. That means that this side of the rope has also 1 kilogram of force. And this side of the rope and this side of the rope, since they are the same rope, they must have the same 1 kilogram of tension. This is what's called mechanical advantage. We have a mechanical advantage of 2 because there is a force multiplication of 2 within the system. However, there's always a trade-off with mechanical advantage. And in this case, we have a length reduction. So for every meter I would pull here, I would only lift the object 0.5 meter. If I pull with 2 meters, the object lifts 1 meter. But why there has to be a trade-off anyway? Like most things in physics, it has to do with conservation of energy. You see, energy, or work in this case, is the product of the force we apply times the distance over which we apply that force. So if I want to put very little force into the system, I have to pay the gods of physics with a longer length. The smaller the force I want to put to lift up my machine, the longer I will have to pull that rope. We know that my machine weighs about 12.5 kilograms. So if I want to lift it up 5 centimeters, I need to put 6 joules into the system. If I use a two pulley system, like we've seen before, I can get away with just putting 6 kilos of force into it. But in return, I would have to pull the rope for 10 centimeters because I will always have to put 6 joules into the system. That's in theory. In the real world, things are rarely perfect, so we might have some losses of energy in the pulleys or in the rope, but it's there or thereabouts. If we have a four pulley system in this configuration, then the situation is very similar in principle. Whatever force I put here will be multiplied by 4 because we have a mechanical advantage of 4 because the tension I put here gets applied on the object 1, 2, 3, 4 times. In turn, we have a length reduction of 4 because whatever distance I pull here will only lift the object 1/4 of that. Props to you if you can tell me why the length reduction is proportional to the number of pulleys we have here. Just leave your answer in the comments down below. And now for the final trick, I'm gonna have one more pulley added to the system, one more movable pulley, that is. And in this situation, I would have a mechanical advantage of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1 kilogram in, 6 kilograms out. And on the flip side, we would have that if I put 6 centimeters of movement, I will get 1 centimeter of movement. And I think this is exactly the system I need for my sewing machine. Doing it with more pulleys would mean that the friction would stop the system from working properly. And since this was 12 kilograms, a system of mechanical advantage 6 to 1 would mean that I only need to put 2 kilograms through my pinky to lift up this beauty. So I've fixed it, and to see what's happening, I've put this fish scale or suitcase scale. Shouldn't take more than 2, maybe 3 kilograms. Okay, 3, 4. I don't know if you can see this, but now I'm at 4, 5. Oh my God. Okay, this is, oh, I know what's happening. The machine stays here instead of just pulling back down with all its weight. So it must be that the friction in the pulleys is not good enough, it's too much. We have too many bends and back and forth and back and forth.
Hello darkness, my old friend.
Oh, but what do we do now? We do what we always have to do when we encounter a problem. We should analyze and understand what's happening here. In our case, we have a rope. Doesn't really want to change shape. For every bend I have, I'm losing energy in just deforming the rope and making it comply to whatever shape the system requires. On the other hand, we have very small pulleys, and between you and me, they are quite cheap, so I don't expect them to be perfect. They probably have a lot of friction inside of them, and being very small, they also make the rope do a very tight turn, meaning we're losing even more friction every time we make the rope go around one of them. So to lift up the machine without losing all of our energy to friction, what we need to find is a system that maximizes mechanical advantage and minimizes the number of pulleys and tight bends that we have to do with the rope. Let me go see what I can find, and I'll be back in a moment for you guys. So here I have the machine ready to be lifted. It's properly rigged up, and this is the pulley configuration that I ended up settling with. So the way this works is very clever, and with just 4 pulleys, we can get a mechanical advantage of 16 to 1. Let me explain. So we have a simple pulley. We've seen this before, and this gives us a mechanical advantage of 2. The clever bit is that this pulley is connected to another pulley that doubles the mechanical advantage again. And that one is in turn connected to another pulley that doubles it, and then another one. So the total mechanical advantage of the system would be 2 times 2, 4 times 2, 8 times 2, 16. Meaning that, yes, I know I will have to pull this scale 16 times the length I want to lift the machine, but in turn, for every kilogram of force that I would put here, I would get 16 of lifting force. And since the machine weighs less than 16 kilos, I should be able to lift it with less than 1 kilo of force. In a perfect world, that is. Obviously, we have a lot of frictions. We've seen the problems before. So as long as we can lift it with less than 3 kilograms, I think the whole rig and my pinky will be able to do the job without breaking. So without further ado, let's try it. Pinky. It is lift, yes, yes, it is lifting, yes! Oh yeah, yeah, we managed to do it. Oh, see the friction problems. But anyway, this is a remarkable result. I mean, I'm still not able to lift it with my whole arm, but I can just pull it with my pinky and it goes up no problem. This is actually one of my favorite things about science, that I can just think about things and then put half as much effort or even less in the task that I need to do. So I'm just going to reclaim the space in my room while you guys hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. And I will see you in the next video. Bye. A factor of 6. Yeah, this is 6, not this. And I'm Alvaro. No, I'm not. Yes, I am. Okay. Hello everyone, I'm Alvaro from Omni Calculator.